is come so on, adorable. I want to hug her. She's come a long way. Rhonda Ross, the daughter of two music industry powerhouses, the legendary Diana Ross and Motown Records founder Berry Gordy. And Rhonda joins us this morning.
Hello, hello, hello.
What is that video from?
I think it's 1979. I hope I'm correct, at Caesar's Palace in Vegas.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and we would do that all the time. That's the one that got filmed, but we would sing all the time. That was part of our growing up with my mother. We'd be on the stage all the time and she would bring us the mic and we'd sing Reach Out and Touch.
What was it like growing up in a household with such a famous parent? Were you out on the road with her? Were you at home?
It's such a great question. We were home. We had a very traditional upbringing in that way.
Yeah.
She would travel, and my grandmother, her mother, would take care of us until she passed when I was about 13. But my grandmother raised us in that regard, but my mother was really very present. She would travel and then get back at night so she could be there with us in the mornings and get us off to school. She was very, very present, yeah.
It's almost a little distracting how much you sound like your mother. Also, just in listening to you speak,
yes, thank you.
Fantastic. We just watched the Motown 60th anniversary special the other day and saw the whole Ross family front and center,
yes,
and at the Grammys,
yes,
and at so many other places. There is such obvious love in this family.
Yeah. Yeah, we really dig each other. Yeah, we like each other a lot. My mother, because she was so present, I think, as a mother, she really instilled in us a love of family and a love of each other and a respect of each other and a sense of what is precious and what is private. In this day of social media, everything is out there,
God.
But we have a sense of what is a precious relationship that we need to nurture and nourish, and we do. We do that with each other.
I bet you must talk to other children of celebrities that you must have moved in different circles with, and I'm sure their experience was not the same as yours, because that's amazing.
Are very different.
Yeah.
And I credit that again to my mother being an incredible mother. So,
wow.
Yeah, very, very different experience.
O'Shea Jackson Jr., the son of Ice Cube, was mm-hmm. in that chair,
yes,
about an hour ago.
Yes.
And talked about just, you know, being raised kind of normal by their family, but still with strict guidelines, and another family that turned out great.
That's exactly it. And for the next generation, myself, him included, and my young son, who's starting to get some notoriety.
We've seen
him. Let's talk about little Rafe.
Raif Henock.
Raif
Henock. He's starting to. People are starting to see the magic that we've been seeing for the past 9 years. He's 9 years old. But what I'm so pleased about is that he is being raised in a family that is normal and understands that the importance of relationship and what is important and what's a priority and all of that. So as the fame comes, he's not knocked over by it.
You call him your miracle baby. Tell us why.
Oh boy, my husband and I tried for him for many. Oh boy. Oh, my heart. My husband and I tried for him for many, many years. We had miscarriages. We you know, didn't conceive and all of that stuff. And we continued to stay.
People don't know how hard that is.
It is hard. And I was young. You know, I didn't expect it. I was mm-hmm. in my 20s. And so we worked really hard and stayed faithful and stayed optimistic. And when he got here, I just stared at him for 3 years. I'm still staring at him.
Do you encourage him following the family path? I mean, this is an incredibly talented family, but this young man shines whenever he is on stage.
I so appreciate that. I encourage him to follow what makes him happy, and that's what my mother did with us. To encouraged us to follow our bliss, to stay true to our desires, and to stay true to our dream, even if there were challenges. And I encourage him to do that, and to stay honest with himself, not to do anything to get fame or likes or any of that stuff, to love himself. And I just think that's so important for our kids these days, to really have a sense of love of themselves. You know, it's so dangerous out there if we don't.
I wonder what kind of special moment this was that we're looking at, where your mom is singing to your dad, Berry Gordy. And this was such an emotional moment, especially singing the Billie Holiday song, My Man, especially. There wasn't a dry eye in the house.
Yeah, mine either. It was an incredible moment. I felt really blessed to be right there. See, I am in the white.
Oh, yeah.
And that's my boy hugging me. We were just having a moment ourselves. It was amazing. My mother and my father, Berry, have a unique and special bond and love that is really unexplainable. They were lovers at one point. They conceived me, but they built a legacy together, and they're friends, and they were manager and managee. I mean, there's a lot there, and they still love each other so much.
Yeah. We're gonna hear you singing coming up in a little bit. What kind of music will people hear if they go see you?
Yes, my music is, I write my music. I'm a songwriter, and my music is I like to call it inspirational neo soul. So it's a mix of jazz and soul, but the lyrics have content. I like to call it music for grown folk. So it feels good, but the music, we're talking about something, the same things we're talking about now, what it is to love yourself, what it is to raise your child, what it is to be a child of a parent that you care about, what's precious, what's important, all of that is in my music.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Rhonda. Thanks
Rhonda
for being
Ross
here.
Rhonda Ross and her husband, Rodney Kendrick, will be performing tonight at City Winery on Randolph Street. Will Raif be there?
Raif will be introducing us.
I love it.
He's the star of the family.
There you go.
Go to citywinery.com for more information. We're going to be hearing from Rhonda coming up. Thanks for being here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rhonda.
Nice to meet you.